the end of the season. And I don't mean the mating season for cats. No, I mean the football season. I've got 10 predictions for you. Let's get straight into it. Number one, Ollie gone. Yeah, and I don't mean me. I might be gone by the end of the season, who knows. But Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, the baby-faced assassin, Man United's manager. He'll be gone by the end of the season. Sorry guys, I'm really tired. Now these are not, I have no insider knowledge on this. This is just my opinion, my prediction. Is that Ole Gunnar Solskjaer will have left by the end of the season. And he will be replaced by Maurizio Pochettino. Okay, so let's go into it quickly. Spurs got their new stadium last season. Poch said he'd be around to take Spurs into the new stadium. That's what he's doing this season. They started pretty badly in the league, losing to Newcastle the other day, only getting a draw at Man City, and they beat, who did they beat? Aston Villa, beating 3-1. So not all great. Spurs haven't at all. He's got Eriksen dangling like a bloody idiot. I might leave, I might not. Don't know yet. I'll let you know next week when the Spanish transfer window shuts. You know, Dele Alli has lost form over the last couple of years. He's brought in Lo Celso on loan, but he probably liked the deal permanent from the start. He's brought in Ndombele, who looks like a really good player. But maybe he's just ready for a change, Poch. He's been talking about it quite a bit over the last few months. Maybe I'll be here, maybe I won't, sort of thing. And I think if United had gone for him at the end of last season rather than getting in Ollie on a permanent, I think Poch may have had a decision to make there. Instead, United didn't go for him. And I believe they'll make a move at the end of this season to bring Pochettino in with Ollie gone. Second prediction. Because I don't think United will finish in the top six. Actually, I've just given away one of my predictions. Second prediction, Chelsea will finish outside the top six. I know Lampard got himself a win the other day at Norwich, but that Chelsea team, without being able to sign players for the next two windows or two seasons, is really going to struggle defensively. I mean, when you got Kurt Zouma as part of your back four and you're fighting for a top four place or a top six place, I don't fancy your chances. Andreas Christensen, Antonio Rudiger and Kurt Zouma, as we said, I don't see that being strong enough. I don't think Kepa the keeper is very good. Midfield not too bad, but Jorginho, yeah. Kante obviously, so he's going to be a great player. Barkley, yeah, he's alright on his day. Ruben Loftus-Cheek, he's out injured at the minute. Hudson-Odoi, out injured at the minute. Pulisic, still finding his feet. I just don't see Chelsea being a Tammy Abraham up front with Olivier Giroud and Michy Batshuayi. I can't see him getting a top six myself. Third prediction, Raheem Sterling will be top goal scorer this season. Everything the lad hits at the minute goes in. He got a hat-trick on his in their first game against West Ham. Scored against Spurs, didn't he, I believe. Scored again the other day against whoever they played against. My mind's a bit blank today, guys. But he scored. I'm so tired today. Fourth prediction. Leeds, Fulham and West Brom to be promoted from the Championship. Leeds making a second run at it with Marcelo Bielsa. Fulham under Scotty Parker with Mitrovic up front, and it's a very good team in general. And West Brom with Slav in charge, Slaven Bilic, who, okay, don't have much, he has no Championship experience in the slightest, but he has a good footballing brain and good footballing qualities in terms of how he wants his teams to play. themselves a draw, didn't they, against Everton on the weekend? But there's that in the lead against the Spurs, lost 3-1. They lost their second game, I believe. I can't remember who against now. And I just think, despite the fact that they signed about 12 or 13 players, I don't think... Oh, they lost to Bournemouth, didn't they, the week before? Tommy didn't give away a penalty in like the first minute. I just don't believe Villa have recruited very well. It's all anyone can go and spend 150, 200 million on players. But it's the type of player, the quality of player you bring in, which will decide whether or not you stay up. Southampton, they brought in, what's his name? Shea Adams, yet to score in the Premier League. I think they did well last season under Ralph Hasenhüttl, but maybe lacking something this season. Early on, anyway. I know they were on the weekend, didn't they, against... I can't remember. They won on the weekend, I remember that. It wasn't Brighton, was it? Was it Southampton, Brighton? Away at Brighton, I think it might be. And Crystal Palace, yes, they beat United. I mean, how bad is it? United couldn't score one penalty against Palace with Rashford hitting the post. Yet Colchester scored all five of theirs against Palace. You couldn't make it up, really, could you? Knocking Palace out of the Carabao Cup. My sixth prediction is that Liverpool will win the league this season. Last season they went so close, but missed out by 1 point, 1 or 2 points to Man City. This season, Man City have already dropped 2 points against Tottenham, and without Vincent Kompany in defence and just in the dressing room, I think City will drop more points between now and the end of the season. It's inevitable. Whereas Liverpool aren't any weaker. They didn't lose anyone. Okay, they didn't sign anybody, but they are stronger than they were last season. Just by the fact that they're together for longer now. And they got Brewster as well as backup to Mane or Salah or Firmino. I think, and they've got Oxlade-Chamberlain for the full season. Adam Lallana is fit and ready to go. Yeah, I'd say it's looking up for Liverpool. The top six, my predictions are Liverpool, Man City, Arsenal, Tottenham, Leicester. I said before United won't finish top six, I forgot I'd said they would in this prediction. I think they'll finish sixth behind Leicester City in fifth place. Liverpool looking great at the minute. Man City, they'll be top two easily. Arsenal are looking quite useful. Yeah, they look crap against Liverpool, but apart from that, they got Spurs on the weekend. Probably beat them, knowing my luck. Spurs in fourth. I don't know, they might be looking to get that this season after seeing that game against Newcastle on the weekend. And Leicester, I think they'll come out of nowhere. You got Yuri Tielemans, you got is it Daniel Breyer, the Belgian lad? I think he's Belgian anyway. You got James Maddison, Harvey Barnes, Jamie Vardy, Ayoze Perez. I think they might need to strengthen in defence after losing Harry Maguire. And I think they probably need a better striker than Perez. Just somebody's going to get him 25 goals a season, because I don't think Vardy will do that this season, though he'll probably get about 15. I'd say future's looking good for Leicester under Brendan Rodgers. Next prediction, this is number 3, 6, prediction 8, managerial sackings. I don't think there'll be stacks this season, but I've gone with Ole Gunnar Solskjaer. I don't think they'll last. I don't think United can afford to have United do. The board can't afford to see him do so badly if the weekend's anything to go by. Ralph Hasenhüttl at Southampton, I know he was their saviour last season, but if it looks like they're going down, he'll be given the boot. Javi Gracia, how bad is their early start to the season? I know they're winning the Carabao Cup on Tuesday, but in the Premier League, 3 losses on the bounce. Crazy. And Marco Silva, yes, they went through in the Carabao Cup on penalties at Lincoln. You'd silver, how much they've spent. I heard last night that since Farhad Mashiri, the owner, had come in, they spent 400 million of her five transfer windows. That is equal or second only to Man City in that time. So United get a stick, but Everton has spent more than United in the last five windows. My ninth prediction is that Dan James, the young lad at Man United, will be the young player of the season. I mean, he scored in his debut game against Chelsea. He scored in his second game at Old Trafford on the weekend against Crystal Palace. Should have been an equalising goal, but it was an equaliser. Didn't get us a point, no. Thanks to Patrick Van Aanholt's winner for Palace. And I just think this lad's going to take the Premier League by storm. He's not fazed by playing at Old Trafford, playing against Premier League teams. He doesn't look light in terms of muscle or whatever. He's just ready to go. It's great to see. So he's my prediction for Young Player of the Year. And my 10th prediction isn't a Premier League one at all. It is Champions League. And I'm predicting that Barcelona will win the final. I think they'll win the Champions League this season. When you consider they have Messi, Griezmann, if you wonder why I said like that, it's because I heard the other day, like you say his name, not Griezmann, but Griezmann. Who else you got? Suarez, Dembele, if he doesn't leave. No, Coutinho, okay, that's fine. You got the young Dutch lad who signed for them, who joined up with them this time around. What's his name again? Oh, bloody hell. Not Delete, obviously he's the defender, but he's the old teammate from Ajax, who looks very, very good. I can't remember his name off the top of my head. And then you got so many other good players in that team as well. Rakitic is still there, Busquets is still there. The defence is weak. I ain't gonna pretend it's not. But attacking wise, Barcelona should have more than enough to win the Champions League this season. Especially if Neymar ends up going back to Barcelona, then you might as well forget anyone else doing anything against them, because they'll just wipe the floor of every team in front of them going forward. Now, we thought they would with Liverpool last season in the second leg. Look what happened there. Fair play to Liverpool. Anyway, guys, that's mine.